Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. In today's video, we're looking at how you can connect Loom, which is a video recording application for Chrome, with Notion, and how you can use this as an onboarding experience or an experience that you could use with your team to help improve the communication around a certain topic or a project. So in today's video, we're showing you how you can connect Loom and the likes of Notion together. So let's dive in. So guys, here we are inside Notion. As you can imagine, many people like to have an experience inside of Notion where their team can onboard. I've been thinking recently a lot about this for our website creation. So we have obviously the Keep Productive blog and articles and content for the blog. So we have this lovely table that allows us to see all of the upcoming articles, topics, what they're assigned to, and all the due dates. Now, we've been using this since mid-August, and we started implementing it officially sort of end of August time. So it's been around for a while, and as you can imagine, we've been slowly honing in on it. But the one thing that we've been doing in the last couple of months is trying to look for more people to write on the blog all about productivity apps. So as you can imagine, with that, we need to be able to onboard people, show them how to make the best articles, and that is something that we're going to be doing in an official manner. So as you can imagine, what I could do is start adding an onboarding checklist so that when they land on this page, because we share this page with all of the creators on the Keep Productive blog, once they land on this page, they can open it up and get started with the checklist, or they can actually sit with this when they're writing the article and actually help improve their experience. So as you can imagine, let's begin to create this area. I won't fully create it today, but I'll show you how you can connect Loom with it so that you can showcase how to specifically do this inside of the blog. So let's just create a new page here, and let's title the page Onboarding or Article Checklist. So I'm going to kick things off by just populating this checklist a little. Okay, so there's a really simple article checklist, and I probably will go back to this and add loads more detail. So as you can imagine, just something that is very simplistic for this video. But what I want to do here is in the writing section, I want to be able to add a few mini tutorials on how they can improve their writing experience inside of Squarespace, for example. So what I want to do is I want to make a little bit of space down here ready to add that. Now I'm going to go over to Chrome, which we use for Squarespace. So I'm just going to go over here, open up Squarespace, and as you can see, I'm just going to go and open up the blog. Okay, so now I've got an article up that I want to be talking about. I'm going to go over to the Chrome extension that I've downloaded for Loom. And remember, Loom is a free app that you can download from the Chrome Web Store. I think all you need to do is sign in through Google or Slack. Now I'm just going to press this one. And as you can see, what pops up is this screen. So you can see me here. You can actually access screen and camera, screen only, or cam only. And I'm actually going to only click the current tab, and you can see it's recording through there. Now you can access the detailed advanced settings so that you can see. But in this case, I'm actually going to start recording and basically just build up an idea of how they can best write. So here we are. So for best practice, my recommendation is to keep the H2 headers really simple, to add an image below them, also to try and weave in other articles that we've created or articles that are relevant to the article itself. So as you can see, that's a really simple Loom. So I'm going to go in the top right hand corner, I'm going to press stop, and what will happen is it will automatically create a video. So as you can see here, it's got a share link. So I'm just going to copy the share link and I'm going to go back to Notion. Now, if I go for a slash and type in Loom, you can see the embed comes in here, and I'm going to paste the shareable link here and press embed Loom. Now, what should appear is a video ready for the person that's going through this checklist to click on and learn from. So if I click play.
So here we are. So for best practice, my recommendation is to keep the H2.
So as you can see, this is a neat way to be able to help onboard your team. You could add it next to the pieces that you're doing. So for example, I just shuffled this one up like so. You can add more and be able to use these as almost like a guidebook for people that come on. Now you could also use it in a different style way. You could also go onto here. So if I just went to here, for example, create tables inside of Notion and clicked edit page content, and I decided I wanted to add a Loom in here using the article. So for example, I wanted to produce some feedback on that article. So for example, let's find the actual article that I created. I believe it was on here. Let's just take this article for an example. I could go over to Loom and actually quickly record a little bit of feedback using screen only. And what I could do here is be like, just something very simple, like a bit of feedback like, Francesco, let's include more links throughout this. Let's try and weave more detail about this image here. You know, we need to improve the zoom in here. It needs to be closer. And we also need to get a better search for YouTube there. And you can see it's a really simple example. So I'm just going to click the tick. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this one here, embed Loom into Notion. So for example, if I was myself and or I signed this to someone else, I'd come in and I could go to open and I could watch a little bit of feedback on how I could improve my account. So that's a really simple way on how you can use Loom and Notion together. I highly recommend checking it out. I actually use Cloud App as a way to share a lot of my stuff. But again, that isn't supported currently inside of Notion. But guys, hopefully you enjoyed this feature. Hopefully it gave you a few ideas to whether it's team use you use it for or yourself. It could be something really simple you leave yourself. Anyway guys, huge thanks for stopping by. Hope you enjoyed this feature. Make sure to check out the PDF for Notion if you're a brand new newbie. And also, please do go to the Skillshare class and become a student there. Anyway guys, thank you so much for stopping by today. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.